Hey, how's it going, America? It's me again, the quintessential stud muffin, George Scorpion Hernandez. This is Think Tank Presents The Couch, starring Alligator. My mistake, Alligator, aka shut up, bitch, or I'll stay you with my taser. And Teddy the Bear, call him for free hoes in Union Square. Test you if you have a pair. Check it out, the couch.
As soon as production of the second episode begins, the hyenas receive some unexpected news.
Special edition of The Couch. I go by the name Teddy the Bear. Tonight, today, we're going to be talking about Randy Poffo. Macho Man Randy Savage has left us. May 20, 2011. He died this morning in a car accident in Florida. He had a heart attack. He surely will be missed. And it's unfortunate, you know, he was the best, you know, especially to me. You know, he was one of the most iconic, the characters from my childhood. Till now, I do impressions of Macho Man and whatever. I'm not trying to get special attention or a YouTube craze. We all want to pay our respects, our condolences go out to his wife, all the other talent from that era. And you will be missed, Macho Man Randy Savage. So, without any more bullshit talk, let me incarnate, let me feel the lightning bolt. Look at it! Look at it, you can't see it, I can see it. The third dimension, yeah! The Macho Man Randy Savage presenting The Couch. Let's do it, let's have a little bit of fun, yeah!
Here is a man, turned it around 180 degrees.
180 degrees.
360, and then...
360.
Another 180. Macho Man Randy Savage.
The beat goes on, yeah, and the beat goes on, yeah, and the beat goes on, and the beat goes on, yeah. Sugar is sweet and so is honey. No, macho madness right now. Time distortions. Reincarnation doesn't have to be. No, and I'm living now, yeah.
But the beat goes on.
But the beat goes on, and the beat goes on. The beat goes on, yeah, and the beat goes on, yeah.
Every one of us is born with a special ability, a special talent, the little something that makes you different from everybody else. What separates you from the rest of the pack? What makes you unique? What can you do that nobody else can do? Are you a man of iron? Are you a super kid genius that was bitten by a spider? What can you contribute to this world? Are you a scorpion like George Hernandez? The quintessential stud muffin. That's a whole other story. Are you a superhero? Are you part of a league? Are you part of a team? Are you a reptilian? Who is Randy Chango? Are you a man of mystery? Are you a god? Are you a false prophet? Are you a demon? Are you a spawn? Or are you a mutant? You have the genome, you have the DNA code that makes you different.
We form our own. The humans have played their hand. Now we get ready to play ours.
We're gonna talk about X-Men First Class, ladies and gentlemen, the next Marvel movie coming from, not from Marvel Studios, but from Fox. But you know what? It seems like they're doing a really good job. Mm-hmm. Matthew Vaughn, in an interview, he stated that if there are some sequels to this movie, this one is in the 50s to the 60s, the next one he wants it to be in the 70s and the 80s and so forth, which I think is very cool, because if you introduce the X-Men in the way that they were introduced in reality in the 70s and the 80s, it makes perfect sense. I don't think Professor Xavier is going to lose his hair in this one or anything like that, but the dynamic between Xavier and Magneto, perfect. It makes for good storytelling, a good movie. Great actors. You have James McAvoy, the guy from Wanted, and you know, a bunch of other movies that are really, really good. And you got Michael Fassbender.
Yeah.
This guy's a great actor. You know him from 300. You know him from
Inglourious Basterds.
Inglourious Basterds.
He also was in Jonah Hex, too.
What's it like to go through life with a face like that? Let me show you.
But X-Men First Class, the one that we're gonna see in the theaters, directed by Matthew Vaughn. You might know him for movies Kick-Ass. He directed Layer Cake, and he did Stardust. He was gonna direct X-Men 3, but he didn't want to be away from home, so they gave it to Britt Ratner. Britt Ratner.
Don't you know who I am? I'm the Juggernaut, bitch!
Could have done so many good things with that movie, Mr. Ratner, but I don't know. Call Jackie Chan and Chris Tucker, man.
Don't worry, it's okay. You better get the hell out of here.
And look at his couch. Somebody threw out a whole couch, and it's in great shape.
Yeah, you put a little Febreze on that, scrub it out a little bit, look great in your apartment.
You know what? I know we have a dangerous job to do here, but I'm taking this. I'm taking this couch.
Well, guys, welcome to the couch. Anyways, Thor was pretty good. Thor was pretty good. I'm a prude when it comes to comic book movies. You know what? Thor was a pretty good fucking movie.
Yes.
We figured out the hammer is,
Mjolnir.
Mjolnir?
Mjolnir.
Mjolnir, I think. The J is like a Y. Right. Mjolnir, you know what? If ask Anthony Hopkins, he's the one that's
the still gonna catch it.
Mighty Hammer Mjolnir.
I really enjoyed the guy that played Loki because there was a scene where he had just discovered that he's
Frost Giant.
Yeah. Which I completely forgot from the comics. And honestly, that was one of the most emotional scenes in the whole movie. The whole theater was like,
what? Because I'm the monster parents tell their children about at night. You know, it all makes sense now why you favored Thor all these years. Because no matter how much you claim to love me, you could never have a frost giant sitting on the throne of Asgard.
Much props to Chris Hemsworth.
Hemsworth? It's another one of those funny words we can't figure out.
I think it was Captain Kirk's dad in J.J. Abrams' Star Trek, the one that died in the over-dramatic, crazy, tearjerker beginning.
Yeah.
Awesome movie, by the way.
Yes. J.J.
Keyboard solo, J.J. Abrams!
Dog coming through. Move on my way. Dog coming through, babe. Dog coming through, babe. Dog coming through. Dog coming through. Yeah. Feel me? That's how we rock. That's how we rock out here, babe. You have seen.
Listen. X-Men First Class, June 3rd. We're getting ready to get our tickets already. And then June is going to be very interesting because besides that, there's Green Lantern coming out.
Green Lantern, yeah!
Finally, DC gets a chance to get a little punch in there because Marvel's getting a freaking
beat down on these guys. They killed them.
Beat down, elbow drop at the top rope.
That's Marvel right.
Comics is 100% domination of Hollywood. Yeah, 100% dominating the airwaves, the media, the internet, but every fucking net that's going on, a fucking fish net, a fly net, mosquito net. You wanna bet, you wanna get, I got the scent. Yeah, came out with an album once, a rap album, didn't really work out, but you know, I still got the skills, the technique. Ooh, yeah!
I do wanna know you had those tendencies, cause you've been running from Nacho like I got a disease. Dude, please, your pay-per-view event was a joke. You're avoiding Randy Savage cause you know you can smoke.
Get a shot of this right here, you hear me?
Snap into a Slim
Savage, boy. If you don't got it, you don't know what music is.
Something bossy alone. I see the madness in your eyes. Yeah, I see the madness in your eyes. Am I gonna be a tag team or am I gonna have to mangle you? Am I? Don't touch me! Don't touch!
Alright, man. I got a serious question. You know, like about a week ago, Macho Man Randy Savage did pass away. He was a former tag team with you, and I want to know what are your thoughts on that? So, what's your career now going to be, Vic? Like?